everybody, what's up? This is Joe with Dino Repo. Just had a new tribe member join us, Roth from Dino Hunters. He came back and he wants to help us tame a quetz that he and Taze came across in the northwestern corner. Taze is rebuilding our old trap we used to use on top of 5050, composed of three regular dino gates. We really just always use wood, and three at the front of the quets, one at the front, you know, two on the side like you see. And he's gonna put like some walls on the back to help kind of catch it, and you'll see that in action here in a minute. And my phone just went off. Excuse that interruption. And three high on the doorway is actually what it is, and two ceilings forward. He ran out of mat. This is going to be an air tame post nerf, so we don't know what's going to happen, so we'll just see what happens. I know stam's going to probably be an issue. We were just doing some tests on this run, and if it doesn't go good, we'll probably go make sure we get over land, so in case we have to drop it, we can drop it. And there's the quetz, 145. Using two quetzals on this. We were thinking we could possibly hop between two quetzes, and that would help with the stam issue. If we're high enough in the air, they won't descend. Taze getting some stam before he goes up there to nab this other one. And I'm just kind of following him behind closely so I can get the action. A little bit of a wreck there, but alright. It's a go. We're after it right now, and he's going to try to get it. It's going to the left now, which is good. Get away from this border. My quest to follow me. Ross on standby on Atera. This is how you do it. You drive in behind them and just kind of scoop them up. They get stuck. You start to trank them, which you're about to do. They will start darting in all directions, but won't be able to because of the trap. I'm gonna put that under him in case he fell or something. Ross just using it to get some stam. And the tranking has begun. I miss the old quetz noises, the sounds they made. These new ones are kind of weird. I miss the old pop, 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 pop. Just never sounds the same as it used to. I imagine the stam's dropping on this one. Well, it actually may not be. But see, too low, it's trying to descend on us, so we gotta bring it up a little higher. And it's down. This is how we used to do it before the nerf. That was about 2 weeks ago, and pretty much infinite stam. You could just stay up in the air and not have to worry about anything bothering it. Perfect aim. If you move the quetz though, it'll fall. So that was the only thing. We were debating here, how are we going to get people off and on if we didn't want to do the quits method of hopping back and forth, if it was kind of like risky or whatever. I was suggesting just drop a person. You see that upside down L on top of the door frames there? Drop a person there and they could just drop down safely, check on it, give it narcs or whatever while it's taming. Taze says you can't starve tame a quits because the amount of time it tames, their food goes below the threshold, the actual food they have, and they'll die. So We didn't really start doing anything here, and you'll see why here a little later. The Quetz actually has taken some damage and we didn't know it. Don't know if it was from this or actually the fall, because we're actually going to have to drop it here in a minute because of the stam issue. And Taze is too heavy, so I gotta go grab the Quetz and put it under them to catch them. Here in a sec. How you do it if somebody's overloaded. I brought a third Terra, but it seemed like the game erased it. I don't know why, but it was rubber banding the whole way over here. Now I just can't find it. Bump this thing by accident. And then we're gonna drop it. Luckily they didn't do anything to it. And the knuckles kinda shifted on top of the generator. And Taze was doing this little test where you, I could see it possibly working if the mechanic to where if a flyer is so low that it automatically lands, if that was an effect, it might work. But I see that the Terra, he puts it on the back of the Quetz and that lets the Quetz follow that bird and tries to get infinite stam that way. But I think the problem is that if it's sitting on the Quetz, just like if you're a human sitting on the Quetz, it starts losing stam. But if you get on a Terra and fly, the Terra will actually, I mean the Quetz will actually regain stamina just by sitting in the air like it used to by itself. So if for not the landing mechanic, if a Terra is near the ground, you know, then it might work. It would stay airborne, the Quetz would follow it, and they both have infinite stam, just like if you were leaving them in the air and just away from them. But we just wanted to test that, and now that we've kind of seen that it doesn't work, and the Quetz's stam was slowly going down, we just decided to drop it, and we just drop it right here. But we noticed, don't know if it was from the actual trank or during the fall or whatever, it took some damage, and Taze wanted to actually retrap it, which we'll see here in a minute, and it's not going to take near as long as before, and we'd actually drop it again at a less high distance and just put some spikes around it. So we're about to do that in just a second. We're just kind of clearing the area of any hostiles. That's what Ross doing. I'm just kind of watching it. Any day, Teddy, any day. Yeah, they patched it. What they said, but what did they not patch? Yeah, right here, Tay said he heard some kind of noise, like, you know, they can get hit by like a crossbow or something, I don't know, or just get hit in general. So, we woke it up with stems, we picked a bunch of stem berries, and now we're just retrapping it. Try to get that taming effectiveness higher than it was after it got hit, you know. Which Tay said you could do, so we did it. I'm probably going to have to clear that tree. So let me get something and peck it. On it, boss. Now we get to watch it get shot all over again. How lucky for you guys, you can watch the same quits get tranked twice. First my long little finger, always clicking the right foot. Pretty bloody, but it actually didn't take a lot of damage on this next thing. I think the TE was like 97, whereas before, didn't really know because it didn't have any kibble on it. So pretty much when you down a quest, just go ahead and put kibble on it. You kind of have to, because you can starve tame it for a little while, but eventually you gotta feed it. That's coming from Taze now, so if you guys think different, do tell us in the comments. We just have hypotheses. Yeah, it took a while to wake this thing up. Here Taze is trying to drop it. Look at this little slide effect. Like, how the heck is it staying on the... Scrape it off on the tree. And I'm not hearing anything like a hit or anything I'm just talking about. So I guess it's fine. My little trick to land in a quest. Hit space real quick and drop for like forever. And then hit space for hit the ground and hit space again to land. And I'm gonna spike this off on the high ground to where the predators would come and try to... F it up if they ever did. Keeping the sea to our back. And we're gonna probably goof around while this thing is taming because it's gonna be a while. That first part of the video, I just want to show you how we used to do it, which was so much easier. All we had to do was just camp with the quets. Not to worry about anything. I don't know how I got this wall up all these pillars around us, but it did. Half a wall anyway. We're just clearing out some more crap. Found a wash shop's dossier. It's over here on the far west by this crazy looking peninsula. They're about halfway done. Night has fallen. I think Taze has got to go to work here soon. So he's going to drop his stuff on the quets and bed back to base and log. Before that, we're probably going to mess around and shoot him. And just die. Come on, Taze, make it interesting. Yeah, let Roth kill you. Okay, I got piked in the head after being tranked. His first death. He was gonna go KO a Stego, but couldn't. And as usual, Taze has to start shooting me with darts. And when he does that, I start bringing out the lethals. Cover. Let me find some cover. Right ahead. Like I got him in the hip and in the eyeball. And I actually forgot to get his stuff after about 5 minutes. That would have been bad. Ascendant rifle, crossbow, and shotgun darts. And keep finding monkeys everywhere. Just had to start shooting them. Watch this shot. Drag that monkey. Taze again. Death number 3 coming up. I don't know. He got tranked that time. A Roth and his trank arrows. He's really got to go to work, but Roth wouldn't leave him alone. Monkey. What you want, monkey? You're not getting away. Monkey disappeared. There he is. All along, this Quetz is still taming. Gotta do something with the boredom. Roth just started cooking everything we started killing, so I just started bringing it to the fire for him. On the fire with you, monkey. Damon Quetz, about 70%. Another check later, 92.9. Yeah, it's about tame. Maybe one more bite. Here we go. And then this 145 in case we wanted to breed it. You've probably seen the stats. Need to see them, just pause the video. Wherever I check the inventory. I guess Ross going to head back with this and I'm going to demo all these spikes. Okay, back at base, and I got an ascendant platform saddle for it. Okay. I'll start sending some stuff to SC because Roth wants to breed some more T-Rexes to do boss battles maybe eventually. I'll see you guys.